Welcome to the Wonder Pets Vodcast. I am Jerusalem Emmanuel, aka Pak. And we have...
I'm Saina Vasquez, and I'm Ming Ming.
I'm Trisha Kinasilia, and I am Trini.
We are so excited to be here today, and thank you for joining us here. We are in our home, safe and well. And we are so very ready with our formal attire. I think this is formal. And we are so prepared and excited in this podcast, right?
Right!
We want to thank the Google Meet for being the venue of our online podcast. And before we start discussing and talk about things and chit-chatting, where this WONDERPET started?
Well, this WONDERPET thing started in the first semester of the school year. Back then, we were assigned together for an activity. And we started chit-chatting, and we didn't even realize that we built a team. A strong one. And it's now called WONDERPETS.
What a story. It's so very inspiring. And may I ask, before we started, what is a VODCAST? Because actually, it is my first time doing this.
Podcast uses audio, while VODCASTing uses video, video podcasting or reading. So it adds video to the downloadable sound file to the podcast listeners, and the term VODCAST is the combination of the words video and podcast. So by the way, why are we here today, So what's the purpose of this VODCAST and what is our topic?
Thank you for that, Ms. Saina. Today we will talk about our time management. And it's not about just the three of us, but including our viewers and our audiences, because we want to know what they're going through in this new normal education about time management and study habits. And it's just we want to share our experience with one another and learn from it, and also share it to the world that our experience or what we've been through going through is just normal. That sometimes we keep telling ourselves tomorrow is the best day to start this activity, but when tomorrow comes, it will be tomorrow again. It's just the endless cycle of procrastination, and it's just normal. But we are here today to discuss and talk about how to avoid that habit in our lives. Once again, I am Tak.
I'm Ming Ming.
I am Lini.
This is WONDERPETS Podcast.
Go WONDERPETS!
So, let's start our discussion by defining what time management and study habit is. Ms. Trisha, can you tell us what is time management?
Well, activity or process where you set goals for things you want to get done and be able to utilize properly your time and be productive.
Thank you for that very insightful answer. Crystal Kane once said that if you want to be more productive, you need to become master of your and study habit. Let's go to the next question for Ms. Saina. Ms. Saina, what is study habits?
So basically, it's what you do or practice while studying that results more effective study session. Study habits is different to our behavior in relation to studying. So study habits is a combination of study method and skill.
A wonderful answer, Ms. Saina. And now, let us proceed to our question and answer portion. I'm gonna ask you a question and just answer it and tell us about your thoughts. Are you ready, ladies? Beautiful ladies?
Yes.
So, the first question is for Ms. Saina Vasquez. Ms. Saina, how do you prioritize tasks?
So, I prioritize my task and arrangement according to their deadline. That means I will do a task that its deadline is nearing or approaching. But this also depends on the task. Now, so if the task needs a lot of preparation, then I will prioritize that first.
The next question is for Ms. Trisha Nasilia. The question is, how do you limit distraction?
Well, I limit distractions in a way that I set aside the objects that I don't need in my current work, so attention will not be drawn away from the activity that I want to finish.
Trisha, your working environment is kind of focused in one goal, so you must undo necessary things. And the next question for Ms. Saina Vasquez. The question is, how do you manage deadlines?
Same thing as before, I prioritize and arrange my tasks according to deadline, but this time I will have some factors included, which is internet connection and time. As you know, my internet connection is not that stable, and because of this, a lot of time has been wasted.
Thank you, Ms. Sai. And the fourth question is for Ms. Trisha Nasilia. The question is, why do you think it is important to manage your time well?
You should not waste any of your time without benefiting from it. Managing your time well is important to be able to reach your certain goals and not totally consuming all the time you have. And it is important because in managing your time, you will not have a hard time following a path in reaching a certain goal.
And the next question is for Ms. Saina Vasquez. Ms. Saina, how do you balance work and personal life? I think this question is so very important. How do you balance work or activities in the school and personal life?
Honestly, if I have to put percentage on how I spend my life today, that would be 70% school and 30% my personal wasting of time. Not gonna lie, that's a huge percent for school, honestly. I think that's so big. So this is because of, firstly, it's internet connection, and second is time. But right now, I'm balancing this. I'm going to make it like 60 or 40 this moment. So if I'm not feeling well, then I will give myself a break. You don't want to push yourself, and you do what you want to do because your health deserves it talaga.
I think you, Miss Sina, right? It's right na we must first prioritize our health. Thank you, Miss Sina. And the last question for this Q&A portion is goes to Miss Trisha. Miss Trisha, the question is, describe how you manage stress at work.
How do I manage stress? I am the type of person that avoids stress. I enjoy the things that I do to avoid it. But if ever I encounter stress, I usually just go on without my, just put an optimistic or positive mindset every time, so I won't be in a position where I can't finish a task or I feel empty or tired. Like, your work day should be your happy days, diba? So seeing positive sides and everything helps a lot. How I cope up with stress at work.
So and now let us proceed to the last part of this podcast. So the last part of this podcast is realization and understanding and learning about art. So the last part is about parang pulot of the day pa sa magandang buhay pa, di ba? First na lang, guro, I'm gonna say my realization and understand. For me today, I realized that we all have times that we feel tired sometimes and lazy. But the important is that we are aware of what we are doing, and we can do something better. And lastly, it's not about how little or how many tasks you have, but it's about how you manage your time. And it takes a lot of self-discipline. You must discipline yourself, not having social media while working on your research like that. And speaking of time management and study habits, I believe on the quote that says, nobody is too busy, it's just a matter of priority.
The realization that hits me hard in this podcast is the fact that I have very poor time management skill, which leads to mostly why I procrastinate in my schoolwork. And I also realize what the right thing to do are, but I choose to ignore and proceed to a habit where I waste my time doing nothing. I realize that time is a very great factor in our lives. We should really know what things to prioritize to be able to become successful in your goals such and such. So from now on, I can say that I will start being productive, and I will learn to manage my time well, and also I will set my priorities right.
Dersha, you know that moment when you have the task and you know that it's wrong to procrastinate, but then again you tell yourself, oh, I'm gonna do this later, I will finish this like for about 5 minutes, I will finish YouTube, and then I'm gonna do it that, and then you end up watching YouTube for like an hour straight. So I feel you, Dersha, because it's so frustrating sometimes of how data and time you wasted. So my realization is, in short answer, I've learned that all of these things depends on yourself talaga. So especially managing responsibilities and priorities, in the end it all comes to you. The decision you do right this moment will certainly bring a result later on, and it can be positive or negative. But the most important thing to remember is that nothing worth having comes easy. Struggle brings progress whether you succeed or fail. You either advance or learn from it. If you learn from it, your mistakes are proof that you are trying, you are working on growth. Life is not stagnant and does not pay. Even if it seems you're in the face of an unbeatable adversary, it will better than nothing. If it's worth it, it's not easy. So procrastination, all of our mistakes, we can learn from it and grow from it also.
I am so happy sa the answer of Miss Sina and also Miss Trisha. If that thing didn't challenge you, then it will not change you. That's all for this day, and I want to thank Miss Trisha K. Nasirio for having us, and Miss Sina June Vasquez for sharing good ideas and very insightful wisdom and knowledges to us. And that's all. Thank you for tuning in. Once again, I am Pretty Boy Jerusalem K. Manuel, aka Tak.
I'm
Sina
Vasquez, and I'm Ming.
I am Trisha K. Nasirio, and I am Ming.
And
this is
the WONDERPETS Podcast.
Go!